Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about air resistance. But before we go in detail about air resistance, first we'll talk about what we have done in the previous video. So let us recap. We learned that friction is a force which slows down moving object. Friction takes place because of roughness of any surface. Friction can be harmful as well as beneficial also. Friction force has lots of impact on our daily life. Air resistance is a force which works when an object is moving through air. Generally, we do not notice air resistance when we go slow in air, but the moment you go fast, you can experience air resistance. For example, when you go fast on your cycle, then you might have observed that your hair pushes backwards. That push is known as air resistance. You might have observed during our school assembly, when there is a flag hoisting, the flag used to fly nicely when there is a fast wind. That is because of air resistance. If you have played with kite, you might have noticed when you pull the kite towards yourself, then air pushes it upwards. This push is air resistance. So we can say that air resistance is a resistive force, and this force we can experience when we move in through air. Now I will talk about factors affecting air resistance. There are two factors which affect air resistance. They are surface area of an object and speed of an object. First, we will talk about surface area of an object, that how surface area of an object affects air resistance. Let us watch this activity first. Through this activity, we are going to understand how surface area affects air resistance. Take two papers of same shape and size like this. Mass of both the papers will be same and they will experience same gravitational force because mass is same. Now squeeze one paper and turn it into a ball. If you see the surface area of paper ball is lesser than plain paper. Now take both of them at same height and drop it at the same time and observe. As you can see, ball reaches first than paper. You can think now why and how. Through this activity, we have observed that if an object have more surface area, that will experience more air resistance compared to the object which has less surface area. In case of speed, the object which is having high speed, that object will experience more air resistance because objects moving with high speed pushes more air on the way. That's why high speed object will experience more air resistance. So these are the two factors, surface area and speed, which affects air resistance. Next is how we can reduce air resistance. We can reduce air resistance by streamlining. You might be thinking, what is streamlining? Streamlining is reducing surface area of any object. For example, if you have noticed the front of bullet train, front of aeroplane, the shape of bird, the shape of fishes, all these are streamlined shape, means in front they have less surface area. Let us watch this activity to understand more about streamlining. This is a very simple activity through which we will understand about streamlined shape. Take a piece of paper and fold it in this way. See the foldings. This is a paper plane and this shape is known as streamlined shape. So as you can see, it can fly fast in air. That's why we say that streamlining reduces air resistance. The more pointed the tip is, the faster the plane will fly. All of you try this and see which type of plane goes faster. Air resistance can be very useful in slowing things down. For example, safe landing through parachute is only possible because of air resistance. So air resistance is somewhere useful for us and somewhere harmful. After watching this video, you should be able to answer these questions. First, what is air resistance? Second, what are the factors affecting air resistance? Third, how we can decrease air resistance? Fourth, name any five objects which have streamlined shape.